Again, that hearing getting underway in just moments. Let's bring in our panel as we wait for it. Jeff Zeleny is back, along with our Nia Malika Henderson, our senior political reporter. Asha Rangappa is with us, CNN legal and national security analyst and former FBI special agent, as well as Michael Zeldin, CNN legal analyst and former special assistant to Bob Mueller at the Department of Justice. So nice to have you all here. Nia, let's begin with the word of the day from the White House, and that word is transparency. Nothing to see here. We have been fully transparent. If you look back, it's anything but the case. The Saturday statement that didn't disclose the purpose of the meeting from Donald Trump Jr. was now reviewed, we've learned from the New York Times, by the president himself. They had to change that drastically by Sunday. The message Sunday was Jared Kushner and Paul Manafort had no idea about this meeting. That was not the case. They were forwarded this email with all of the information about the meeting. That's a low bar for transparency, is it not?
It is a low bar for transparency, and that is what we heard from the president, sort of praising his son for being transparent. He tweeted again saying that he felt like his son was open and honest in his interview last night as well. But what we've seen here is really, sort of rolling disclosures about this meeting and shifting stories from Donald Trump Jr. about why that meeting happened, this idea that it was about adoptions in those initial emails that we've seen, at least part of those emails. We don't know that we've seen all of the emails about these conversations that he had with that Russian government lawyer. But there was certainly in those emails that we've seen so far no discussions about the meeting being about adoptions. In many ways, you feel like this could be the tip of the iceberg, right? I mean, this is one set of emails. Were there previous discussions that we don't have those emails? Were there subsequent discussions about any of this? I think from the White House's point of view, and certainly Donald Trump Jr.'s point of view, he wants this to sort of be put to an end with that interview that he had last night. It's certainly the sort of public relations part of it, but certainly the legal discussions of this will be ongoing with the special prosecutor and certainly on the Hill as well, more discussions about this. And you can imagine that there might be more information to come. John McCain has talked about this whole episode as a centipede with, right, with 100 legs and many more shoes to drop. So we'll see what happens going forward.
It's got a disclosure at gunpoint. Now, Asha, you know, Donald Trump Jr., Jared Kushner, Paul Manafort, the President of the United States, are all of their interests aligned right here? They all now have their own lawyers giving them their own advice. It seems to me there might be some conflicts here, especially given what Evan Perez is reporting. You know, Jared Kushner, aside from the president, the only one now in office who had to fill out the security form.
Sure. Their interests aren't aligned. I think this is... It's been on a collision course for a while now. All of these people should have lawyered up a long time ago. I was actually surprised that Donald Trump Jr. only recently got his lawyer, because a lot of the statements that he made were very unwise from a legal perspective. And at this point, I think that you're going to start seeing a lot of fingers pointed at each other. They're going to start talking when the FBI starts closing in.
So, Michael Zeldin, because you have worked with Bob Mueller when he was at the Department of Justice, we know now that he was, you know, looking into this meeting, these emails, he knew about them in the days leading up to this. How does this change how he looks at things, what questions he asks, who he wants to talk to? How does this now change the investigation?
Well, it's a bit of a sea change from the standpoint of this is the first direct indication that we have in the public domain of a contact between the Trump campaign and Russian surrogates. And so to the extent that there was rumors of collusion or a conspiracy to aid the Trump campaign by Russian operatives, it remained, you know, sort of vague. This is now much more direct. And so I think it gives Mueller and his team a little bit more impetus to root out what was at the bottom of this thing. And so I think, as with the intelligence committees on the Hill, this will be just evidence of their need to be thorough and investigate all of this stuff. Not that Mueller wouldn't have been otherwise, but this really says we've got to look at this, because this is a direct link between the transition, the people on the campaign, and the Russian operatives. Yeah.
I mean, you know, Jeff, I want to take you down memory lane here. This was a campaign you covered very, very closely. You know, this meeting was what, June 9th was the
yep.
meeting between the president's son and the Russian. This is what President Trump said on June 7th, right around those days. This is what he was promising then. Listen.
I am going to give a major speech on probably Monday of next week, and we're going to be discussing all of the things that have taken place with the Clintons. I think you're going to find it very informative and very, very interesting.
Okay, so he said that after the emails were sent back and forth with Donald Trump Jr., emails were told now by Donald Trump Jr. he never told his father about. That's the story from Donald Trump Jr. Ultimately, when Donald Trump Sr., the president gave, or the president candidate, gave that speech, there wasn't really much new there, but this was right at the beginning, just prior to the wave of everything that happened with hacks in Russia and this and that, Jeff.
It is so interesting to look at that really weak period of time, John. On June 7th, was the day of the final round of primaries in the election cycle. Donald Trump was basically already going to be the Republican nominee, but Hillary Clinton was just trying to wrap up her Democratic primary fight, and the California primary was on that day. But on June 7th, when then-candidate Trump was giving that speech right there, a meeting had already been set up. As we learned from the emails yesterday, on June 3rd was the first request for the meeting. And then 6 days later, on the 9th of June, that meeting actually happened. So it certainly looked, in hindsight, watching this all sort of in order here, that President Trump, candidate Trump, was expecting something to come on the Clinton campaign. Now, it is, you know, we don't know that he knew about that meeting at all, because certainly this is the time that the general election battle was joined here. But it certainly seemed like he had something on his mind that he was going to give a speech the next week. And you're right, that speech didn't really have much in it, much new in it. You know, a lot of new back and forth. And at this point, both sides were going after each other fairly hard. But very interesting that he would deliver that speech that day in the middle of all of this. And then again on June 9th, on that Thursday, when this meeting actually happened, Donald Trump, candidate Trump, was at a fundraiser, his first fundraiser at the Trump Victory Fund at the Four Seasons Hotel, about a block, from Trump Tower. He was back in Trump Tower all of that afternoon as the meeting happened. Again, we do not know if he knew about the meeting, but it certainly is important to remember and point out this was a very small campaign operation in terms of the number of people. The Clinton campaign, headquartered in Brooklyn, had hundreds and hundreds of people. The Trump campaign, very small, particularly back in June. So some people wonder, and this is what a subject of the questioning likely will be, how could the president candidate Trump not have been aware that this meeting was going to happen, because it certainly seemed so juicy. Donald Trump Jr. said, I'd love it if this is actually a real in terms of having information for a Hillary Clinton. So watching all this back in sequence, it certainly is interesting.
But may I add something to that timeline as well?
Very quickly,
Which is that the email says we could use that stuff later in the summer. And then, of course, later in the summer was the WikiLeaks leak. Yeah. So they all sort of tie in together.
Donald Jr. also said in that email, especially later in the summer, putting an emphasis on the importance of later in the summer, which he completely downplayed in the interview with Hannity last night, saying, well, I didn't really need it then, so I thought maybe later on when things weren't as busy.
It was interesting. I don't remember the follow-up question.
I didn't get
any pushback on that. Yeah. All right, guys, stick around. We have a lot more to discuss.